Hello, this is Sylvain Henry, Canadian Spartacus. Today's video message will be Mad Strategy for Chemtrail Truth Action. Mad meaning Mass Action Demand, which is our group in Facebook. We are among the millions who believe that humans have a right to clean air, water, food, and clean government. We are against politically produced pollution such as fluoridation, genetically modified foods, and chemtrails. Chemtrails are those persistent white lines formed by planes flying at high altitudes, lines that persist for hours and eventually become clouds. These lines sometimes stretch for hundreds of miles and can even be seen via satellite. Even though planes fly over all nations, only about 30 countries have any chemtrails, especially NATO countries. Our immediate goal in this action, in our initiatives, is to start a dialogue with our unreachable government leaders about chemtrails, to get their official response on this issue, and to ask them, for our sake, to stop this activity now. Now I would like to discuss our strategy, our tactics. Create a group of active chemtrail activists. Done. 2,500 members in three different groups that we have created in Mass Action Demand. Then create a hyper network, a network of networks of chemtrail groups. Done. I'm in communication with the leaders of these groups, and each group would have anywhere from 25 members to 2,000 members. Write letter to leaders template. Now this is done and it's being translated into many languages. We have written a template letter that people can use, modify, edit as they wish, and send to the leaders of their countries starting on January 25th. So the next step is to invite several thousand people to email their national leaders starting today, June 25th. That is done. And this is ongoing till the 4th of July. Then identify main countries being sprayed. Done. That's 27 countries with our empirical information. That's based on an online form where I collected the information, feedback of some 300 people from 27 different countries. Then create a chemtrail confessional hotline. That's done. The number is 613-600-LEAD. LEAD standing for 5323. This confessional hotline is for everybody, but especially for those chemtrail pilots, for those engineers of the chemtrail planes, those who service the planes, and those who bring the chemicals to the planes. And what we're asking is for them to contact us. We do not need to have information that will identify them, like their phone number, email address, and so on. We just want the information that will lead us to the truth. Also, in exchange, what we will do to them, if they prefer to go into greater detail, we will give them phone numbers or email addresses of whistleblower protection programs and so on in their city. Then create an International Whistleblowers Day for whistleblowers. And that's done. And that date has been scheduled for 11-11, of course, 2011. And a number of people are petitioning for that day to be reserved to be the first day, International Day for whistleblowers. They need our protection. They need our respect. They need reward as well. Start showing chemtrail movies at cafes. And we do this in a unique way, using creating an indoor-outdoor screen. What I mean by this, using essentially a white bedsheet over a large, like Bayview window, we project at a cafe that has about 30 seats, a movie inside. People can see it inside, but the people outside sitting at the tables outside of the cafe, or people walking along the sidewalk, can see the movie with the same exact same quality as the people inside. You should try it one day. It is fun. Except they see the reverse image, of course. Then set up a geoengineering on trial mock courtroom, and that has been done. And today, the 25th, was the launch date of our first hearing of the this mock trial. We are using real evidence, real witnesses, and real experts on the subject of chemtrails. And we're very proud to say that we have attracted the attention of environmental law students associations in Canada. They're very interested in this activity, and chances are they're going to participate and play one of the roles of either prosecution or defense or jury or so on. By the way, and media is also going to be participating in this courtroom, this virtual courtroom, which, by the way, there are several courtrooms depending on language. We have a Danish room, Serbian room, and we have an English, which is the international one. And each room can contain up to 1,000 people, but we have a way to, silence the masses inside and keep the main actors communicating. Now, collect photo and video evidence with date and time stamps and location stamps for the trial in the evidence room, and that is done, and more evidence, photo evidence, video evidence is being added as time goes by, including documents, okay, and testimonials, video testimonials, audio testimonials. What has been the most effective thing for some reason, which a lot of people may believe in and some people may not? We have created last year a day where we've invited 4,000 people to pray with us for a solution to stop chemtrails. Now, when we did that, is this a coincidence? I don't know. But chemtrail activity in Canada stopped for a period of the last week of June 2010 to the first 2 weeks of July. Was it us? I don't know. Funny coincidence. Then ask friends to contact the visually handicapped, tell them about chemtrails. And that is done. We've started doing that. And because the blind cannot see the sky, okay? And we want to make sure they're included and nobody is excluded from this. Then something that is not done, which is being done, we're making our 7th edition of the MAD, Mass Action Demand newsletter, and which will contain a number of articles, photos, and so on. That would be of interest to the members, and of course to the national leaders, because we're going to be emailing them a copy. What is unique about this newsletter is that the moment the government opens this, receives this email and starts reading the newsletter, people can chat in real time with those people in the government reading the letter. Now, this is quite unique. So for this, for the newsletter, we're looking for more articles to finish it off. Then the next thing we are doing, part of our strategy, is to prepare PowerPoint presentations for community leaders in any country. That is being done. If you or somebody you know would like to give a presentation to a police department, to a municipal government, to the councillors of the municipal government, and so on, about chemtrails, contact us, okay? Then finally, we're asking for volunteers to help us promote these truth action initiatives so that as many people as possible are participating. Now, I'd like to say in ending, we have full faith that our initiatives will unite fellow citizens at web speed to convince our leaders to listen to us for once and to make our priorities theirs as well. We do not want war with other brothers and sisters overseas. That is not our priority. We want clean air, clean water, clean food, clean government. And with your help, we'll build a Taj Mahal of truth, of peace, of prosperity for all citizens everywhere. Thank you. Dare to care and share this message. This is Sylvain Henry, Canadian Spartacus.